1948. The Olympic Games are revived after 12 years. The 1940 and 1944 Games were canceled because of World War II. There is still a military atmosphere here in Wembley Stadium. King George VI is in full dress uniform as Supreme Commander of the British Armed Forces. More than 4,000 athletes from 59 countries pass in review. Two countries are noticeably absent, Germany and Japan. World War II is over but 3 years. It would be another 4 years, the 1952 Helsinki Games, before German and Japanese athletes would again compete. Many of the athletes who will compete in London are still in the armed forces. One of them is Sergeant Mal Whitfield of the United States Air Force. Whitfield is one of the co-favorites to win the 800-meter gold medal.
I was a favorite in 1948. Arthur Wendt was also a favorite for the West Indies and the United Kingdom. He was a 195-pounder, 6'5", and an 11-foot stride. And, of course, matching his stride against my 8-foot stride was quite a competition.
Arthur Wendt, 28 years old, a pilot in the Royal Air Force during World War II. He continued his training whenever possible throughout the war. Many believe Wendt is now too old and past his prime.
Well, I was hoping that if and when there was another Olympic Games, I might make it. But initially, it was the one thing I could do well, and I was determined wherever I was in the Air Force to take my running shoes along and take part in whatever competitions they were going.
The final of the 800 meters. Whitfield and Wendt both easily qualify for the nine-man final. But 29-year-old Marcel Ancin of France has won both his qualifying and semifinal heats. At the start of the race, Robert Chez d'Autel of France takes the lead. Arthur Wendt immediately moves into second place, and Mal Whitfield falls behind Wendt on the inside. At the halfway point, Whitfield makes his move. Chez d'Autel second, Arthur Wendt third. Now Marcel Ancin of France quickly passes runners on the outside and moves into second place. Whitfield is first, Ancin in the black shirt second, but Wendt is again coming on. Now Whitfield, United States first. Arthur Wendt, Jamaica second. Marcel Ancin, France third.
Standing on the dais, receiving my gold medal, I couldn't help but shed a few tears because this was my childhood ambition. And of course, reflecting back on the 1936 Olympic Games and seeing Long John Rudolph win his 800 meters, I said to myself, I too have arrived as the Olympic champion of 1948.
Helsinki, 1952. 27-year-old Sergeant Mal Whitfield has been ranked number one in the world 3 out of the 4 years since the 1948 London Games. In 1951, the only year he was not ranked first, he flew 27 missions as a tail gunner in a bomber during the Korean War. 32-year-old Arthur Wendt is now Dr. Arthur Wendt. Though he had been plagued with injuries since the London Games here in Helsinki, he again will try to beat Mal Whitfield in the 800 meters.
I had a very limited time to prepare myself because, again, I had a pulled muscle 3 weeks before the Games. So I had to get that as right as I could. I would just try and analyze the times the other boys have done, the way they ran the race, and how was I going to run against them so as to be able to win.
July 22, 1952. The final of the 800 meters. Mal Whitfield and Arthur Wendt again qualify easily, but only Heinz Olzheimer of West Germany has won both his qualifying heats. Arthur Wendt immediately goes into the lead. Olzheimer of Germany falls in behind him. Whitfield is back in the pack. It is evident that Arthur Wint will try a different tactic against Whitfield here in Helsinki. He will make a fast pace to try to offset Whitfield's superior finishing kick. Down the backstretch, Wint leads, closely followed by Olsheimer. Wolfbrand, Sweden, is third. Webster, Great Britain, fourth. And Whitfield on the outside is fifth. Into the turn for the first time, Wint leads. Olsheimer, Germany, second. Wolfbrand, Sweden, third. Webster, Great Britain, fourth. Whitfield, United States, fifth. The bell for the final lap. Wint leads, followed by Olsheimer. Whitfield is third. Wolfbrand, Sweden, is fourth. Webster, Great Britain, fifth. With 300 meters left, it is Wint, Olsheimer, and Whitfield. There are 200 meters left. Whitfield leads, followed by Wint. Olsheimer is third. Steinus of Germany and Nielsen of Denmark share fourth place. Down the stretch, it is Whitfield, Wint, and Olsheimer. Now Whitfield first, Arthur Wint second, Heinz Olsheimer third. The time, 1:49.2, the exact same time in which Mal Whitfield won the race at the London Games 4 years before.
He is probably one of the most cold-blooded competitors I have met. On the track, no friends, not even a kind word. Doesn't want to talk to anybody. After the event, perfect friendship. But then if you're a competitor and you're a professional, that's the way it has to be.
Mal Whitfield becomes the second man in history to win the 800 meters in successive Olympiads. In all, Whitfield won 3 gold, 1 silver, and 1 bronze medal.
It probably is one of those situations where if an athlete beats you twice, you sort of begin to develop a complex. I'm not sure what's the reason for it, but irrespective of what time the race is running, I've never beaten him in an 800 meters.
Arthur Wint's Olympic career is now over. In his 2 Olympic appearances, he won gold medals in the 400 meters in London and is part of the Jamaican 4x400 relay team here in Helsinki. But in his 2 Olympic 800-meter performances, he had to settle for the silver medal behind Mal Whitfield.